Brady. Gonna finish up Link's Awakening on this stream because we only got the last dungeon last dungeon and the final dungeon after all this. And we'll see the credits and all that jazz. Might play something afterwards. Elsa. And let's make it happen. Just need to double check a thing or two here. Switch this over some, and there we go. All right. Boop. Boop. And let's do this shit. Last dungeon is that we have to take on all the mini bosses, but only one of them will leave behind the warp. This is a puzzle box, gonna use a control pad to move it so we can clear off all the pits. That way we can make some progress. Treasure in this area, so we don't have to worry about clearing all the pits. Fifty more rupees. Even though the rupees are kind of useless at this point of the game, that's not gonna stop me from collecting them, though. Us having a level 2 sword and the red mail, or clothes, I mean, all these mini bosses will be a pushover. I don't know. First key. Fair amount of treasure in this last dungeon. Sadly, the mini bosses don't disappear. But we can kill them to get fairies, so there's that at least. Pretty sure there's a switch underneath these pots. Just gonna get rid of them. Since I've done this dungeon. Whoop. this guy again. Stone beak. Oh, where's this take us now? This wall right here, which will give us a shortcut to the area below. There's the map. I think I want to go back down those stairs. Yeah. Get a guardian acorn. I have to fight this guy again. Ow. Actually got me this time. Here, we can bomb this spot right here. Which gives us this nice little room, which we pretty certain I have to hit that switch. Just once, though. Something like that. Yeah, that takes me to an area I can't access just yet. We can get a key here if we can cover up all these potholes with this block here. Oh. I'll try that again. Gotta get all the potholes. It gets a bit fussy. Actually, let's try this direction. Oh, what? There we go. here. Here, we don't have to cover up the lava with this block, we just need to make a path up to the upper area. So we got two, perfect. For that. Can't access those. Takes us there. At least we get some items from that. Key for that one. Yeah, we need to find some more keys. There's the said key. There's a key located here, but it'll appear on that ledge up there. We have to attack them from above, as per that owl statue just said. Now, where the heck do I use that key, though? That's the question. So many locked doors. That doesn't have anything important in it. That area needs a lot more keys. Okay, I think I'll just use it on this door then. Thank you. 50 rupees. Now we can go up here, which will take us out of the dungeon, but there's a heart piece. Still missing a heart piece, though. The last warp pit, which is a rather silly spot for it. Down here. So again, we gotta attack these guys from above. Which may take a while because they have to eat these bombs. They each take three. Now there's one of them. Small key that we will need. So we're going to go ahead and go in here, so we can get rid of the acorn. That's another key, and we can get another key here too. Shoot this statue with the bow. There's a key. Another key here, but we gotta watch out for that Beamos in the corner. Now we gotta get to those two dark rooms in the middle that you see there. Now that we have enough keys, we should be able to get into that area. Thank you. we go. Now we got progress. Because this should take us to the one mini-boss. That will not only give us the warp back to the beginning, but will also give us the dungeon's treasure. Oh, fooey, I was afraid that would happen. We gotta go back to that crystal switch and hit that so that those are down so I can actually get the final treasure. Oop. We can bomb this little corner here, too. Charged sword. There we go. I think that's what happened. I hit it with the sword last time, but the beam counted as a hit, so I actually hit the crystal twice. And that doesn't help. Try that again. He's actually a pretty tough mini-boss, because if he actually lands a punch on you, he can punch you out of the arena and send you back to the beginning, which is pretty annoying. And there's the treasure, the magic rod. This allows us to spam a fire spell. Now finally full. That's nice. So now with that, we can access two stairways we had to ignore. That one down there is one of them. Don't know if I can access that. I can access this one. Because with the fire rod, we can now get rid of all this ice. Mm-hmm. Okay, I'm pressing B. There we go. Okay, that takes me to the boss door, but we don't have the key yet. To that first set of stairs we had to ignore. Except we need a key. Exactly where that key is, too. It's located right here. We gotta use the magic rod to light those two torches. For the fun part, this is where the nightmare key is, but we gotta use this thing to cover up all the pits, and there's a lot of them, so this may take a couple of tries. Or not. Or I'd get lucky and do it in the first go. Fastest. Oh. What's that treasure? Yeah. Oh, no. No, yeah, that one's not important. I think it's ointment or something. It's either rupees or ointment, and I already have ointment. Alright, now we can go to that one, I wonder if I can jump that. Nope. Gotta go the long way. Mm-hmm. The last boss. You are finished. I will never let you play the instruments of the sirens. Except sadly, this guy's really easy. We just have to spam the magic rod on him. Like that. Why did you come here? If it weren't for you, nothing would have had to change. You cannot wake the windfish. Remember, you too are in the dream. Thunder drum. Figure out where that last piece of heart is. I think it's in this mess of blocks that I haven't even looked at. As you can see, the magic rod is pretty powerful. Even gets rid of those plants that we had to have Bow Wow eat. Even the big one. Alright, we can access level 2 again. Actually two treasure chests that I neglected to pick up in here. They're probably irrelevant, but I'm going to grab this one at least. Yeah, 50 rupees. It would have been helpful earlier, but oh well. Rupees for a raft ride. Jeez. Well, it's a swim on the ocean, but mostly meant for a mini game that is further down. Navigate. navigate these rapids and try to get coins and stuff. Or rupees, I mean. Gonna have to at least go twice so that we can get all the look at all the things. Yeah, we've already been there. That came out from the face shrine in that one. That's it. We can go back up through this cave. Now we gotta go again. So we can get those three undiscovered spots. Pretty certain one of those undiscovered spots has a heart piece, the last heart piece. Has a secret seashell in it, but it was or no, it's further down. It's the next screen over, I believe. Yeah, there it is. Along with an owl. Okay, no, that's another 20 rupees. Uh-oh. So I'm gonna have to look at a guide to figure out where that last heart piece is. So I know I'm only missing one heart piece. That last heart piece be. Just gonna check a guide real quick. While I do, I will put on some more music here. Well, let's play some from Maple Story. There's some good music in Maple Story. Yeah, here we go. Thank you. Nice little MapleStory music for you right there. So yeah, found out what that heart piece, the missing heart piece, is the one that's outside of the castle. It's in the water. Have to swim for it. Boop, there. No, I'm actually pretty far away from the castle. Now I know how we can get to it. Side of the drawbridge. It's in this area right here. There it is. Go, all the hearts. Perfect on that stuff, so I don't have to buy anything. Thing we gotta do in here. Gotta head back to the library. I'm gonna read this book, I think. Yes. We need the magnifying glass to read this book properly. Need to reread that so I can copy down those arrows. In case anyone's wondering, all these books teach basic skills and stuff. Well, the one up here you need the Pegasus boots to get, and it tells you about the color dungeon, which is a new feature in the DX version, which is what I am playing right now. done. Just need to double check the one more thing. Oh, yeah, I just realized. We are missing two photos. First, we'll take this to warp to Animal Village. How that happens, but it happens. Alright, now we'll warp back to Manbo Pond. Just missing one pitcher. Except that pitcher can only be obtained by stealing from the item shop in Maybe Village. But doing so gets you branded as a thief. As in, it'll change your name to Thief in capital letters, and then if you visit the shop again, then the shopkeeper kills you for stealing. Look at these real quick. If you're wondering why it says print, it's because this version of the game is compatible with the Game Boy printer, and you can print these off if you have the Game Boy printer attached at the time, but emulators don't do the Game Boy printer very well, or at all. That's because it's probably trivial. Whoops, I canceled out of that. I wanted to view all the pictures.
There's the one we just got.
Final dungeon. The windfish sleeps long and dreamily in the egg above. When you play the 8 siren instruments in front of the egg, he will awaken. This, my friend, is the only way for you to leave the island. Tamaranch, I think. Tamaranch.
Yeah.
Tamaranch. There it is, the windfish's egg. Just gonna save state here. And we're just gonna double check a couple things here. Cool. Alrighty. Let's finish this game. Time has come. The windfish awaits. Enter the egg. Alright, now we gotta follow those arrows that we copied from that book. So we're gonna go right. Up twice. Right again, up twice again, right, and then up. All right. We were born of nightmares. To take over this world, we made the windfish sleep endlessly. If the windfish doesn't wake up, this island will never disappear. We would have been the masters of this place. but you had to come here and disrupt our plans. You can never defeat us. Let's rumble. Can't get him with the sword, gotta use the powder. Now he goes into a second form, which is a Ganon from Link to the Past. Just gonna reflect his shots back with the sword. Like that. Nope. Missed that one. I thought he was gonna shoot the scatter shot that he occasionally throws at ya. This one. Oh, come on. Give me the one shot I need to kill you off. There we go. Now he becomes a Moldorum, the first boss. And the next form is Ganon. He's weak to the sword, but using the Pegasus boots allows you to put more consistent damage to him. Now he goes to his final form, Deathhole. You gotta be careful of those hands, because they hurt. And there are two ways to get rid of him. He'll have an eye in the middle, and they'll blink periodically throughout the fight. You can either plug as many arrows as you can into that eye, or you can hit him once with the boomerang. Find the rock's feather allows you to get past those hands efficiently. Gotta wait until that eye opens. There it is. Doesn't open frequently, though. Didn't hit it properly. You gotta hit it just right with the boomerang, I think. Oh. Huh, that's weird. Boomerang's supposed to work on it. Ah, there we go. I guess I had to be closer. This island is going to disappear. Our world is going to disappear. Our world. Our world. Link, you have beaten all the nightmares. Climb the stairs before you. Young lad, I mean Link, the hero. You have defeated the nightmares. You have proven your wisdom, courage, and power. As part of the Windfish's spirit, I am the guardian of his dream world. But one day, the nightmares entered the dream and began wreaking havoc. Then you, Link, came to the rescue island. I have always trusted in your courage to turn back the nightmares. Thank you, Link. My work is done. The Windfish will wake soon. Goodbye, Hoot. I am the Windfish. Long has been my slumber. In my dreams, an egg appeared, and was surrounded by an island with people, animals, an entire world. But verily, it be the nature of dreams to end. When I dost awaken, Koholint will be gone. Only the memory of this dreamland will exist in the waking world. Someday thou may recall this island. That memory must be the real dream world. Come, Link, let us awaken together. Play the eight instruments. Play the song of awakening. Jeez, Link's still stranded in the ocean. Tell this is on an emulator when credits don't show up properly. No, I actually want to check something real quick. Oh, okay, it already is. I can see on the Twitch preview the credits aren't looking too great. There's that windfish. Those two deaths that I had at the first dungeon counted. So I didn't get the perfect ending. The perfect ending would had the would not fade to a black screen, and it would show a picture of Marin, and then you would hear the Ballad of the Windfish, and then the picture of Marin would fade out and reveal Seagull, and then the Seagull would fly off. Then it would fade to black, and then it would say a thank you message from the development team. But no, I had to get myself killed twice in the first dungeon because of that blasted Moldorm. But with that, that is the end of Link's Awakening. Now I need to figure out something else to play. I'm kind of tempted to move on to Oracle of Ages and Oracle of Seasons, but we'll save that for a future stream. Let's see here. I think for now I'll just throw up maybe I'll just continue streaming Kirby's Adventure. Because I know I'm halfway through that. Let's do that. Kirby's Adventure. Just give me a second here. I need to figure this out. If I spell Kirby's name right. Okay, let's game capture on. Let's have you that. Which one did I use? Was it this one? Yeah, this is the one. Give me a sec while I get the thing up. Thank you. take a look at something real quick here. Okay. Alright, let's actually play now. Ow. I don't want to lose that cutter. Sword now. Oh no. UFOs show up in this area. There we go. I like how you get points for destroying the star blocks. That might be a while. I want to destroy all the star blocks. Tornado stops. Oof, almost your shit. Thank you. stupid of me. That up. That's bullshit. I was in the power, for fuck's sakes. I guess wheel doesn't work on this guy. Go.
Thank you.